we are essentially facing a kind of initiatory crisis as a species. I mean, stop playing, stop pleasing, stop trying to impress some kind of voice in the back of your head that's judging you all the time. It's all bullshit, basically. All of that can be so paralyzing and so controlling that a lot of people are stuck in it and they don't even know they're stuck in it. They don't know they're playing a role, actually. They don't know how much of their behavior and their way of showing up is actually just conditioned. It's not really who they want to be. In journalism and in other fields, it's very easy to fall into playing a role. And I can certainly look back at earlier periods of my career when I was kind of almost, I don't want to say pretending to be a journalist, but I mean, I was a journalist, but I was sort of, I maybe had like an idealized idea or a sort of model of what a journalist should be that I was trying to become. And that ultimately was not satisfying. And that's where the shadow of, you know, it can actually become quite self-destructive. And that's where getting too obsessed by like awards or getting too wrapped up in your own, having your name on the story or your own kind of personal reputation can be very destructive. I've been doing various types of inner work for some years, but I'd done very little work in an all-male environment. And I realized through the retreat where we met that there was a power actually in working with other men specifically. And I was keen to work particularly on this feeling that I'd worked with for years of a sense of sometimes feeling inferior or feeling like other people were doing better than me in some way. Always kind of comparing myself with others, men and women, particularly from a sort of professional point of view, and feeling like I was coming up short or I hadn't achieved my potential at some level. And that was something that could be triggered in me quite easily, actually. And I think I realized that there was some deeper root, there was something that even for all the inner work I was doing, I wasn't quite seeing, maybe. And so the program seemed to offer a kind of container where I could almost look at the shadow more explicitly, but most importantly with the support of other men, and work towards kind of resolving it. So through the program, I got to kind of test out other ways of being or other ways of showing up, if you like. And sometimes it was quite hard, you know, conflicts arose, dilemma. I mean, although it was an online program, it becomes very real. There are real feelings involved. There are real stakes emotionally involved in these twice weekly meetings. So there's a real exhilaration around it. And it allowed me at some times to really step beyond my usual boundaries and to kind of be a bit more daring and say things that I may have hesitated to say, and almost practice being a bit more real, actually. Stop pleasing people and stop worrying about what other people might think or feeling like I had to manage other people's feelings, and just saying it as I saw it. And the great thing was that sometimes that was like, have I gone too far? But actually, there were times on the program where other people would then say, yeah, no, that was really right. We agree with you. We just didn't want to say it. Or I felt like I'd hit something. It was like the process that we were co-creating had spilled out of the container and actually was getting very real. And it was almost like this conflict wanted to kind of erupt because they were giving me a chance to sort of step into almost a leadership role or a more... to sort of, rather than being like Mr. Nice Guy and just going along with everything, to say, no, I'm not sure about this. Or I see things differently and I'm questioning what's being said in this group at times. And that's not like a normal program where you're just learning content. It wasn't like that at all. It was like the program had taken on a life of its own and was almost challenging us individually it was almost giving each of us a different challenge in a totally unscripted, spontaneous way. And for me, a lot of that was about claiming my own authority and seeing how easily I can give away my authority if I'm not very mindful. And it goes back to sovereignty, feeling sovereign, feeling like I'm the king of my castle. My boundaries, and yes, people can come in and leave, but there are certain rules and there are certain values. So I think it was very empowering to kind of be able to play with that, but in a real way. You know, what I'd played with in the kind of safe container of Wildman, I've also been able to bring into the workplace, and I feel like I'm much more direct. I'm much more able to say it as I see it, even with authority figures. And we were talking earlier about, you know, the risks involved in that, because obviously as you become stronger and go to your edge, people are going to respond to that differently. But as long as you're kind of mindful, and as you taught in the program, one of the things you kept saying to me was, you know, learn to feel into people, you know, learn what they're ready for. I feel very strong in the office. I feel much more confident in sort of confronting my colleagues with the question and saying, we need to look at this and do it together. I don't want to tell everyone what to do. I want us all to be almost like we did in the Wildman, almost somehow in some mysterious way, collaborating without even realizing it. Because we've created the right container, that magic can happen. And it's, you know, it's difficult to create an equivalent container in the workplace, but you can bring elements of it in, you know, the truth telling, the trust, there's different sort of rules around vulnerability, but yeah, you can have vulnerability. You can admit when you made a mistake and say, yeah, I was wrong. But more importantly, you can also step up and deliver the truth to people and not worry about how they react. And sometimes you watch them kind of, but generally speaking, they're like nodding because they know that they know when they hear the truth, that sort of vibration of truth coming through you. And if you've spent some time getting to know what that feels like we do in the Wildman program, you can be very confident that when you're speaking at work, you're not coming from a place of, you're not acting out some childhood issue with your parents, or you're not coming from a place of grandiosity or nasty. You're not coming from a place of trying to prove yourself. You're just delivering what wants to be delivered, right? And that's how I try to feel it. In terms of my work as a writer or journalist, I would say that I'm less likely to unconsciously edit myself. Like, I'm more alert and having almost the confidence now, instead of feeling like I need to quickly produce something so that, because I'm worried that people will think I'm not producing. It's like, no, I'll produce when I'm ready, but it will be good. It'll be worth waiting, because I'll know when I've hit that place of, now I have something to offer. I'm not just gonna quickly do it for you just so you're happy and the job's done. I'll wait until I know it's done. And I'm in charge of that because I'm sovereign. And in a way, the creative process, I think, respects that sovereignty. Because if you are pleasing, you're too worried about what the bosses think, too worried about fitting other people's agenda, that creative spirit is less interested in working with you. It's about having the confidence to go with my own judgment from within, rather than judging my progress from what comes from outside. And that definitely makes you a better writer, or it's made me a better writer, and is, I'm sure, will make almost anyone, I think almost any creative endeavor or any leadership or any project that is reflecting your real core, that real sovereign core, is obviously going to be more powerful and have that bigger impact. And yeah, I've gone through a few serious crises in my life as a result of this process. It's not been easy, but I do feel much more like me in this, in my work. I feel like I'm much more, I'm not trying to kind of be a somebody. I'm not trying to be somebody, I'm just trying to be me. So it's making me a lot happier, and I actually think it's made me
a better colleague and a better journalist.
Yeah, I mean, I work in the field of climate, and I find this a very helpful way to think about it, is that we are essentially facing a kind of initiatory crisis as a species. I mean, there's no way around this. We are facing a existential crisis, and part of an initiation is the fear of death. You know, the genuine fear that I might be dying here. And I think a lot of people are now consciously or unconsciously entering that process, because we are, our civilization and our way of life certainly is at stake. And we'll have to change. But I think acknowledging this process, facing this reality, and finding a community that can support you in this journey is fundamentally important, fundamentally critical, because we don't know how it's going to turn out. Nobody knows. That's the definition of the crisis. If we knew how it was going to turn out, it wouldn't be a crisis, right? So we're in this kind of historical moment, and that's where we have to go. We have to find these inner resources. We have to go through the pain of it, face the fear of it, get in touch with the grief and all the difficult emotions. But as we go under that, like we did in the Wild Man at some level, we find our courage and we realize that we're only here for a finite time, and we have to make the best contribution we can, each one of us, from the place we're in the time we're in. So yeah, it's tough, but it's much easier if you recognize that it's tough than try to deny it or distract yourself or numb yourself or go into addiction or go into any kind of escape route. You know, let's face it, and let's face it together. And Wildman and other kind of programs where the community is so important really teach us to be in community authentically together and really share and really support one another in a fundamental way. You know, I felt like I knew some of the guys on the Wildman program better after a couple of months of just meeting online twice a week than I actually know some of my very close friends. And it shows that when we consciously create these communities, we can really, really make progress, and we can really transform.